Hello students, so here this is a in this video we are going to start a revision of comparing quantities. So here the question number one is find the ratio of. The first is 15 kg to 210 grams. So whenever we have to find a ratio, we have to see that when we are comparing, the two things has to be in same units. And here one unit in kg and one unit in grams. So here we have to change the bigger into smaller. That means kilogram is bigger and grams is smaller. So we have to change that kilogram into grams. Just. So we all know that in 1 kg there are 1000 grams. So 1 kg means 1000 grams. So 15 kg means 15,000 grams. So here this means 15,000 ratio 210 grams. So this means here this means 15,000 grams upon 210 grams. So grams cancelled. 10 will get cancelled. 1521. Both of them are coming in the table of 3. 3 500 ja 3 7 ja. So 507. One is even, one is odd. So now they can't come in the same table. So the final ratio will be 500 ratio 7. So this is your 500 ratio 7 answer. Now the second part. Again, we have to compare 30 days to 36 hours. We all know that days are greater than hours. So we all know that in one day, we have 24 hours. So we have to change the days into hours because bigger is days. So if one day means 24 hours, 30 days means 30 into 24. 30 into 24 means 720 hours. Now we can put them in ratio. That is 720 hours to 36 hours. Now the units are same. Now we can put in a ratio form. That is 720 on 36. So 36 1 by 36, 36 20. So the final ratio will be 20 ratio 1. So in this way we can find out our ratio by comparing the quantities. The quantities have to be in same units. Now question number 2. In our computer lab, there are 3 computers for every 6 students. So that means here in a computer lab, that means for 6 students there are 3 computers. How many computers will be needed for 24 students? So here we have to find out the number of students that have been needed for 24 students. So here in this question, we are going to use the unitary method. So here in this, we have been asked, we have been given that for 6 students, we need 3 computers. So we will start from number of students. So 6 students require 3 computers. And therefore, if one student require 3 upon 6 computers. So 6 students requiring 3 computers, and therefore 1 student will require 3 upon 6 computers. So now how many students? For 24 students we have to find out computers. So therefore for 24 students, we require 3 upon 6 multiplied by 24 computers. So for 24 students we require 3 upon 6 multiplied by 24 computers. So 6 times 6, 6 4 times 24. So now we can multiply 3 by 4, that will give you 12 computers. So that means for 24 students we require 12 computers. Now, question number 3. Convert the following into percents. So here we have been given a fraction. So we have to change this fraction into percentage. So simply divide here 3 upon 40. Then we get multiplied by 100%. So whenever we have to change anything into percent, simply multiply with 100%. So here we can now cancellation. With 0, 0 can cancel. Here it will come in the table of 2. 2 to the 4, 2 5s are. So now we can't cancel anything. So we get 3 into 5, 15 upon 2%. So we can write here in this fraction. 7 whole 1 upon 2%. So in this way we can change a fraction into percent. Now the second part. Here you can see it is a decimal point. Decimal number. So we have to change. Whenever we have to change a decimal into a percent, again multiply with 100%. So here first remove the decimal. Here we can say that here there are two decimal places. So here you all know that every number has one as a denominator. So we can remove this decimal and increase two zeros in the denominator. So it will be 100. This 100 will get cancelled by this 100, and decimal has been finished. So we get 1235%. So in this way we can change our decimal into a percentage. Now question number 4. In question number 4 we have to find the first part. In first part we have to find 1% of 1 hour. So here whenever we have to find out percentage of any quantity, here the unit is hours. So it is 1 hour, so we have to change. We all know that in 1 hour we have to change into smaller units, that is 60 minutes. So here we have to find out 1% of 60 minutes. That means 1 upon 1% means 1 upon 100 of minutes multiply. In 1 hour we can write as 60 minutes. So here we can cancel it, 0 with 0. And here in the table of 2, 2 3 the, this become 2 3 the, and 2 5 the. So it will get 3 upon 5 minutes. 1% of 1 hour means 3 upon 5 minutes. Now we have to find out in second part the whole quantity. We have to find out the whole quantity if 12% of it is 1080. 12% of it means we don't know the number. So let number be x. So if we take a number as x, 12% of it means 12% of x is means equal, that is 1080. So 12% means 12 upon 100 into x equal to 1080. So this fraction will go on the right hand side and it will become 1080 multiplied by, this will get reciprocal, it will become 100 upon 12. 1080 divided by 12. So 12 under 12, 1290. Because 12 90 gives you 108 and it is 0, that is coming in 90. So therefore the number is 9000. 90 multiplied by 100 gives you 9000. So the quantity will be, required quantity will be 9000. Now question number 5. Meeta saves rupees 4000 from her salary. That means here Meeta is saving rupees 4000. If this is 10% of her salary, so that means the 4000 is 10% of her salary. What is her salary? So we have to find out her salary. So let salary be x. And then we have assume salary as x. So saving, here we have been given saving of Meeta. And saving of Meeta is 4000, and we have been given a saving percent, that is saving percent is 10%. Saving of Meeta is 4000 and saving percent is 10%, and we have to taken as savvy as x. Now here this means saving of a salary
is equal to ₹4,000. So saving percent of a salary is rupees how much? 4,000. So saving percent means here saving percent is given to us 10%, and we have taken as salary as X. So 10% of X is giving us ₹4,000. So 10% of salary means 10/100 into X equal to 4,000. So this, to find out X, this fraction will go on the right hand side and get reciprocal and multiplied with 4,000. It gives you, it will become 100/10. So now we can cancel it. 0 will go with 0, and therefore Meeta's salary will be 400 multiplied by 100 gives you 40,000. So here the Meeta's salary is rupees 40,000. So in this way we can find out a salary. Now question number 6. Divide the sum of a triangle in the ratio 2:3:4. Find the value of each angle. So here we have to divide the sum of a triangle in the ratio 2:3:4. So we all know that sum of a triangle is always 180 degrees. So sum of a triangle is 180 degrees. Here we have been given a ratio 2:3:4. So first we have to find out a total ratio. So to find out a total ratio, add all the ratios 2 + 3 + 4. This gives you 9. So total ratio is 9. So now we have to find out the value of each angle. So the first angle, to find out our first angle, here the formula to find out our first angle will be first ratio of all total into sum of a triangle. We have to divide, because the sum of a triangle is 180, so that's why we have to take in as 180. So first ratio is 2, total is 9, so that means 2/9 multiplied by 180%. So now we can cancel with the table of 9, 9 with 9, 9, 20. So this gives you 40%. So 40% is your 40 degrees, sorry, 40 degrees is your first angle. Now second angle, again the second ratio divided by total ratio to 180 degrees. The second ratio is 3/9 into 180 degrees. 9 with 9, 9, 20. So 3 into 20 gives you 60 degrees. So second angle is 60 degrees. And the third angle, again the same, third ratio is 4. Total ratio is 9 into 180 degrees. 9 with 9, 9, 20. So this gives you, 4 into 20 gives you 80 degrees. So first is 40 degrees, second is 60 degrees, and third is 80 degrees. We can add this and we will get 180 degrees. 40 + 60 = 100, 100 + 80 = 180. So in this way we can find out each angles using the ratios. Now question number 7, the cost of a flower vase is ₹120. If the shopkeeper sells it at a loss of 10%, find the price at which it is sold. So here in this question 7, the cost of a flower vase. So flower vase means in which we are putting the flowers and decorate them. So here that means we have been given a cost price. Cost price is equal to 120, and the shopkeeper is selling at a loss of 10%. That means we have been given a loss percent, and loss percent is 10. And now we have to find out the price at which it is sold. So that means we have to find out a SP. So SP formula, to find out a SP, the formula will be 100 minus loss percent into CP divided by 100. So 100 profit minus loss. Loss is 10%. CP is 120 upon 100. So this gives you 90 into 120 upon 100. So here 10 will get cancelled by 10, and this 10 will get cancelled by this 0. So 9 into 12, and 9 into 12 gives you 108. So rupees 108 will be your selling price. Selling price will be rupees 108. In this way, we can find out a selling price. Now, question number 8. Selling price of a toy car is rupees 540. If the profit made by shopkeeper is 20%, what is the CP of this toy? So here we have been given SP. SP is rupees 540, and we have been given a profit percent. The profit percent is 20%, and we have to find out a CP. So CP formula will be CP equal to 100 multiplied by SP upon 100 plus profit percent. So 100 into SP is 540 upon 100 plus 20. So this gives you 100 into 540 upon 120. So now we are going to cancel it. So 0 will get cancelled by 0. 12, 4 3 jar 12, and 4 25 jar. 4 3 jar 12 and 4 25 jar. And 54, 3 1 jar 3, 3 1 jar and 18 jar. So 3 18 jar 54. So 25 multiplied by 18. 25 multiplied by 18 gives you, therefore CP will be 450 rupees. So 450, 25 multiplied by 18 gives you 450 rupees. That is your cost price. Now, the last question is question number 9. Find the amount to be paid at the end of 3 years when principal is rupees 2700 and rate is 5% per. So here we have to find out the amount. To find out the amount, first we have to find out a simple interest. So here the principal is rupees 2700, time is 3 years, and rate is 5%. So first we have to find out a simple interest. And simple interest formula is P principal into rate into time upon 100. So principal is 2700. Rate is 5 and time is 3 upon 100. So 20 will get cancelled by 2 zeros, and it will be that it is 27 into 5. 27 into 5 multiply 27 by 5. 5 7 jar 25. 5 2 jar 10. 10 plus 3 135. 135 multiplied by 3. 5 is 15, 3 is 9, 1, 10. This gives you 3, 405. So you will get rupees 405 as simple interest. So simple interest coming in 405. So now we have to find out amount. And amount formula is principal plus SI. Principal is how much? 2700 plus SI is 405. So the final answer you will get as 3105. So that is, therefore, amount equal to, this is amount equal to rupees 3105. And these all sums I have done in the revision. You have to practice them, and I am going to give you the same type of sum in your worksheet. And remember that you don't have to submit your worksheet, only practice them, and practice all the sum worksheets and sums I have done in the revision for your term 1 exams. And all the best. Thank you.